could never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my number's going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freezer. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna...
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Dallas Cowboys and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. As of this morning, summer officially over. It's time for autumn football, and we're underway on EA Sports. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Ezekiel Elliott, a bad start there, a big loss on their first play from scrimmage. It's second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, third down. He was all over that route defensively. Now, they had two picks last week as a unit. Couldn't quite grab that one.
Patience, Grasshopper. Patience. It's early in this game, but you like the fact that they're around the football early. They're going to be upset they didn't haul that one in. But at least they're there at the moment of truth to make a play on it.
By the way, where did the Grasshopper thing come from? I know it's been around for a long time.
Yeah, you know, I'll have to tell you that some other time.
All right. Back to football. So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Was hoping to make a play there on the return with his speed. Instead, he makes a play for the other side.
Yeah, and how many times have we heard coaches say, you know, sometimes it's not really about those X's and O's we draw up. It's about those Jimmies and Joes. And when you have a punt returner, he's one of those Jimmies and Joes, one of the best athletes. He's unable to make the play that they were seeking, though.
Wait, set, 29, Alpha, 54. He don't know no better. Check, check.
You don't know no better.
On first and 10, here's Brady. And oh, right away, he lost the football. But it looks like a Buccaneer was able to corral it. Yes, the Bucs have it. Tampa Bay keeps the possession.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Now the first carry for Ronald Jones. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Let's go. You tighten up.
From the gun on third down, Brady. Oh, it's Godwin. It's complete. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. On first down, Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. Touchdown. Tampa Bay. Mike Evans. ends. His third touchdown now on the year as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
And on the first drive, 3 and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. It's a big play for the Cowboys on third. 42 yards.
Well, we spent a lot of time exalting the offensive masterminds in this game, right? They draw up these beautiful plays. They look so perfect up on the board. But occasionally, sometimes you just say, throw it up and let him go get it. How about that play?
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. This is Elliott. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
No running room for Zeke on first down as he'll maybe get a yard out of that. The Pro Bowler Muhammad Wilkerson brings him down. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. They'll try the right side with Elliott. A strong broken tackle on that one. And then they get him to the ground just shy of the 15. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd and 2 situation. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard. So here's Greg Zuerlein now as he'll try for the field goal. This a 33-yard attempt. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, then no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13. First down, Tampa. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Now a pass hauled in downfield. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Tom Brady with two first quarter touchdown passes as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts.
Because
once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
I hope this is broadcast.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Fielded about a yard deep. They'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. The penalty, it's Elliott. And an alley to run. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Oh, you got deep.
On second down, Elliott, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
He was brought down by Levante Higgins. A gain of a yard brings up third and inches.
Outside zone, here it comes. Inside, inside, and outside zone. That's
the job. On third down, Elliott, and he's able to get it to the 33, good enough for a first down. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott, eluding the pressure right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So they say no to the penalty. The incompletion stands. It'll be second and 10.
And what they want to do is go ahead and take those downs away from them. You never want to give extra snaps to any offense. That's how you get hurt.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll try to throw now. Prescott. This one complete to Jordan Reed. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety. Oh, that's tough to defend.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up. Two minutes gone by, second quarter.
Looking neat. Affirmation. I hope you got it.
You should know what cover is, man.
On third down, it's Prescott.
Okay, you play football.
And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. Okay. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 41-yard line.
You ain't see that.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust. That's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Elliott going to bite off about 7 on that one. A good run on first down. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Now Prescott. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Levante David coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's 3rd and long. To throw is Prescott. Out to his left. And now he'll let this one go deep.
Yeah.
Thrown across his body and it's intercepted.
Sucks,
picked off at the 13. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Not
the best of plays here as a quarterback. You're right-handed, rolling left, trying to throw it that far downfield.
I remember a coach of mine saying, son, that's the equivalent of trying to get the car keys out of your pocket with your opposite hand while you're trying to run. You just can't do it.
A throw left side to start the drive is complete.
He's
taken down right at the 45-yard line.
He threw for 4, 162.
Give him 30 yards there.
Bro, you from Boston?
It's not a surprise
the
when
man
you
I'm playing next to.
To watch
hey,
because
bro,
you know
it ain't nothing personal.
Player,
you just got something
so
against Boston, motherfucker,
right
now. I don't know why.
They just want to get
y'all
did.
We don't like y'all. Easy.
That's complete to his receiver, Gavin. That's good for a Buccaneer first to pick up of 12 yards.
I could be there.
I like that one, partner. They go back to back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
That throw by Brady, incomplete.
That's Brady.
A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now. We'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action.
Whoa, Brady.
The throw on 2nd down by Brady is incomplete. He was looking for Chris Godwin that time. And it's 3rd down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because any completions on 1st and 2nd down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give him another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the 1st down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Brady. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Xavier Woods with a pick. And this one will be brought back to the 22.
The good old cover 3 defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, and break on the football when it's thrown, and pick it off, just as we saw there.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Don't try my corners like that.
Incomplete.
Get the job done.
Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's 2nd down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes his quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Prescott on 3rd and 2. Flushed out right. He can run for
shitty
it.
Shitty offense.
Maybe not exactly what they had in mind, but that scramble good for 6 and a 1st down.
Dak, you suck.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a 1st down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit.
Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first round pick, Demarius Randall.
Everybody doesn't eat, B. Everybody doesn't eat, B. You need a soy sauce. You need a fucking soy sauce.
Say, what's going on with your scheme?
Everybody
Maybe
doesn't
we should
eat,
look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
The spare ribs, all that.
So after the INT, it's Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones.
Oh, shit.
He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeout as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Throwing again on second down. Brady. He completes it to
Jones. Me. Shrimp.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people.
Better than mine too,
and if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Brady now on first down.
Got him. Oh, you baited me. That was tough. I knew that. I didn't think you had that in
there. They are in an interception mood on defense. Had two nice interceptions a week ago. Now two here in the first half.
Yeah, we call it ball hawking. And the only way to truly be good ball hawks is not guessing.
Hope you get a man on a man.
Anticipation. It's studying and understanding what they like to do. And beating them to the spot
right
and creating big plays.
Yeah,
they're watching the film and it's working.
You're praying that you get a man on a man. That's all it is, bro. I mean, the same fucking play.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half.
Commish, where's the commissioner? I don't hear the loud one.
Kill. They keep on the ground with Elliott. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And he's all the way down to the 13-yard line.
You got balls or what?
Left and there's the timeout.
Get a field goal like a...
In field goal range and a chance to tack on three before intermission. Not time enough for a play and then a timeout, you wouldn't think. So with 4 seconds left, they're going for it. Final play of the half, Prescott. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown.
Yeah, that was so shitty.
Amari Cooper, as time expires in the first half, as they are now just an extra point away from making this a three-point game. Oh, he missed it. No good. So this remains a four-point game. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Bucs with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They have the lead now. They'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Here we go. Check 31. Spot.
X3. 218. Chop. Ozzie. Hey, Zoo.
Check it. Reload.
On second down, it's Jones. And an alley.
That was some
brilliant
shit. That nigga's too fast. You ain't catching him, bro.
He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Way too fast.
Ronald Jones. His third touchdown now on on the year.
Audible. He sucks.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
We're lucky, and hopefully, you know, I get a block on a block, and, you know,
about set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their halftime hole now even deeper, and they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Now Prescott.
Pick. Why? Everyone can get a pick, bro.
Devin White, the rookie out of LSU, there to bat that one away.
He's going to throw one to everybody.
What a difference a week makes.
Wait your turn.
Last week, he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week, he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
I could run one defense
the whole
game. I think
we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going
to
hold that number. Not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense... they spent a lot of extra time on game film.
Oh, no.
And came up with a really
big,
good plan to chip away this time.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
It's taken in at the 9. The goal. Uh-oh.
He had his sights on the end zone, no doubt, but is brought down after a huge return there.
Hey,
and the Buccaneer offense will be set up well as they take
over. Play with me. I play. They lit out there in Tampa right now. Brady got them boys lit. You ain't got no chance, bro. He found out you're from Boston.
From the gun, it's Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. He is caught. But the bank judge right there to say,
yeah, we're trying your fucking user skill.
Mike Evans,
okay?
The one
yeah.
he was looking for. And that'll bring it second down.
Definitely try his user skill.
53! 54! Check the outs, check the outs, check the outs.
To throw again, Brady. And this is caught by Evans. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to...
Ooh, my bad.
He's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line.
And that's the second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And that will extend their lead even further. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. One here?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along. But their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Well,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys' offense. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
They go to Elliott again.
Give me that. I play linebacker. Come on now.
Tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up
linebacker. Linebacker, you ho. Linebacker, you ho. That's what we do out here.
Cooper was the target there. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
I mean,
think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because of zone? Is he picking up man to man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. Ho.
I'll be fucking you.
Brady now hitting on 2/3 of his passes, 10 for 15 so far. First and 10. On play action. Now Brady. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. Jalen Smith. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure it out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
What would the dime look that time on defense? Just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on fourth. They'll go for it. It's Brady. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 38. The Bucs try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And the Cowboys defense is going to get him the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious?
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Devin White came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Check before he falls to Mike. Check pass, check pass. What do you think?
This one out quickly to Amendola. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Prescott now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Another carry tonight for the workhorse, Elliott. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. 1 quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Check, check, and two, check, and two.
Hey, Phil. 47, 26.
From the 45 on second down, Prescott. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Amendola, the intended receiver.
The Bucs take over 1st and 10 at their own 44-yard line.
Hey,
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Check, 55, Mike.
53, Linda!
Mike,
Brady now on first down. Let's get that. He can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Dontari Poe marches in for the sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen.
They turned into a really nice play.
On third and long, it's Brady. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the
pick they